I'm joined live by our favorite infectious disease specialist, Dr. Peter Chin Hong, here with more insight on the norovirus, what we all need to know before our family vacation, our cruises, or in this case, going to summer camp. Doctor, thank you for joining us this morning.
My pleasure, Mel. So norovirus is highly contagious. It's very common. And, there are some things that you can do to help protect yourself and your family.
So let's look at patient zero, so to speak. How are they coming into contact with this virus? Is it the spread of feces, or how does that happen?
So norovirus is a virus, and it has a very protective shell around it. So it can survive in the environment for many days. It can survive, hand sanitizer. It can survive certain heat and cold temperatures. So somebody doesn't have to come into contact with somebody who has symptoms, because it could be everywhere in that environment where somebody had left that place before who might have been sick.
Yikes. Okay. And we know, we've seen this go around in cruise ships. I mean, it's notorious for spreading around in close-knit spaces like that. And you said it doesn't take a lot of people in order to be infected by this. That's how contagious this virus is.
Yes, definitely. So you need probably fewer than 100, sometimes 10 to 50 virus particles to become infected. And you can compare that to other diarrheal diseases like salmonella, where you need thousands to become infected. But norovirus is just a few. So you're like minding your own business, walking around. You touch something, you touch your mouth, and you hadn't washed your hands. It could be fairly easy to catch.
And this can also be very serious, right, for people who are immunocompromised. I mean, especially also little kids who have to go through this painful experience.
Yeah, so kids, the elderly, people who have compromised immune systems can have very profound symptoms. So you can have this. One of the pearls of norovirus is that it's not just watery diarrhea. You have it coming from both ends. So you have projectile vomiting, you have watery diarrhea. So you can imagine you lose a lot of fluid. And that's why the very young, the very old, are very much at risk. And people who are immune compromised just produce a lot of virus once you get infected, and therefore their symptoms can have a big impact on them.
Now, that's horrible. We hate hearing that. It comes out of both ends. Yikes. Now, the summer camp that this happened at, Shady Creek, they posted, they said what they're worried about is kids showing up to camp who are asymptomatic. They're not showing any symptoms at all. That can happen, right, with this virus?
Yes, so after symptoms, it's not very long, but some people, depending on the individual, can continue to shed virus in their feces even after they have no symptoms. Of course, when you have symptoms, you're shedding the most virus. It's kind of like COVID, right? In the beginning, you can have virus, but then it kind of drops off. But then in that period after symptoms, there can still be some virus, but it then goes away. So that's what they're talking about.
And doctor, real quick, you said this can actually stand up against hand sanitizer. So what are some of the ways we can protect ourselves?
So the number one point for today is hand sanitizers don't work. You need to wash your hands the old fashioned way for 20 seconds. So think of happy birthday.
Okay.
Think of your favorite Beyonce song.
Okay, cuff it up. I'm going to sing that while I'm washing my hands. Thank you so much, Dr. Peter Chin Hong, for talking to us about the norovirus. I know a lot of concerned parents are watching this right now, so we so appreciate your time.
My pleasure, Mel. Thank you.